guys, John here, learningguitarnow.com. And in this lesson, I want to show you how to play a 12-bar blues solo in the key of G, and it has a bit of elements from Billy Gibbons and Warren Haynes. It's more of a rocking 12-bar blues. Pretty fun to play this kind of style. It's using four different positions from the minor pentatonic scale, and it's kind of a couple different levels. The first section is not that difficult and kind of moves up in difficulty as the solo progresses. To get the tone for the lesson, I'm using my Germino Classic 45, which is a JTM 45 clone, and I'm also using the JHS Charlie Brown with it. We'll go ahead and take a look at the first couple licks for free, and if you'd like access to the complete lesson with the interactive tab, backing track, guitar profile, their neural DSP Tone King preset, check out the All Access Pass. All right, let's go ahead and start the lesson. Okay, now I'm going to break down the solo for you into eight separate licks. Let's go ahead and start with lick number one. Sounds like this. Okay, so for lick number one, what we're doing, we're in the first position, minor pentatonic scale, key of G. I'm starting right on the first beat, and I'm using my third finger. I'm gonna add a slight rake here. Just let it gradually die down, so I added the rake. So that's gonna happen for one, two, three. And then these last two are gonna be eighth notes triplets, you count them as three. And then on the next bar, hitting the fifth fret. Just a lot of attitude in that bend. Two, three. Bend that slightly, that third fret on the G string. Let that sustain and add some vibrato for four beats, you know. One, two, three, four. Now I'm gonna bend again. Except I'm going to bend it one time and then pull it down, but I'm not going to strike it the second time. And just a kind of similar phrase, a little bit more notes, barring my first finger here. Pull up and down. Then we got... Then we're going to the four chord of the C. I'm sliding from three to five on the G string. And adding some pretty heavy vibrato. Okay, so that's it for lick one. Okay, lick two sounds like this. Okay, so for lick number two, we're moving into the second position, minor pentatonic scale over the four chord, the C chord. So I'm just sliding in here like this. So we came off this lick. Very easy lick, five to seven slide. Six, eight, six, eight, there's a root here. Then classic, you know, blues lick. Slide backwards. Pull off to three. And then you're gonna slide backwards, pull off, release here, and bend that first finger slightly. Five, five. Now bend that third fret slightly. Now do this Chuck Berry type thing. You know, not terribly difficult. You're here, Warren Haynes, Billy Gibbons, any type of blues rock, especially with Les Paul, you know, using those type of licks. Just sounds really mean on this type of a 4-4, just like, you know, that type of really driving beat. You hear ZZ Top and, Government Mule, especially, you know, Warren Haynes playing that type of groove a lot. So it's not terribly difficult of a lick, just getting the vibe down. notice that I'm not striking the strings very hard. Especially, you know, Billy Gibbons uses very light strings. And so if you're using light strings, you can't like kill everything that you're playing so hard because it's going to drive it out of tune. If you crank up the gain like this and you're playing with more distortion, you know, you can just barely really strike the strings. I'm barely hitting them. I'm not going. Not doing that. I'm barely trying to keep everything loose here. The vibrato, very relaxed feel. I'm not tensing this arm. So that's one of the things also to take note of is don't strike everything so hard, especially in this section right here. Okay, so that's it for lick two. Okay, lick three sounds like this. Okay, lick three, very kind of similar to the lick previous. It's a really good exercise if you're not doing this type of a thing. The Chuck Berry move, you know, barring your first finger on the third fret, B and high E. It's just straight up eighth note triplets, 1, 2, 3, 2 through 3. Huh, kind of hard to say that. You might be easier to count like 1 triplet, 2 triplet, 3 triplet, 4 triplet, because that's the rhythm that we're doing. We're 4, 4, 1. 2, 3, 4, 1 triplet, 2 triplet, 3 triplet, 4 triplet. So if you're not good at doing that, that's a great exercise to do daily just to get that down. And this would be a great exercise to do. So you just do this. And then 6, bend on the, slightly on the B. You don't have to bend it all the way to the G note. Like that. Then bend up the high E. And do it in time. If you can't do it in time, slow it way down. You know, 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's a great exercise to do, lick three, if you're not good at doing it. And then, you know, as you get better at it, keep increasing the speed. With a pick, I like to go down, down, up. Down, down. It works for me. You'll notice my first finger is kind of muting that G string. That's what everyone always has problems with. You know, you bend that and you hear when you got this. I'm so used to doing it, it's hard for me to get it to sound out. But if you're doing this, you know, you're getting all this other junk to sound out. Use that first finger to mute that G string right there. So that's a great thing to do, just get build up speed. Cool little exercise. In the very end, you know, you're just sliding backwards. It's another classic move, sliding back. Release, hitting fifth fret, and we're gonna let that sustain for a couple of beats. 1, 2, and having that slide down. It's another classic thing you hear blues rock guys doing. This gives a really mean, a lot of attitude when you do something like that. I'm just doing it around the 15th fret. Adding a little bit more intensity to what I'm playing, this little notes in lick three. Okay, that's it for this lick.